At the last class, ya shabab, we have stopped, I think, here in this slide. What we did in the previous class, we have studied the decimal fractions. So I expect now that you can do all the operations related to the decimals. And also we have studied the exponents, the powers, just introduction to them. And also at the end of the previous class, we have introduced you to the radicals. So to make it so clear for you, let me go to the next slide and I will explain there. I think we have stopped here. We said in the previous class, what we mean by the nth root of A. If the nth root of A equals to B, this is equivalent to saying that what? A is equals to B to the power N. If N is is even, there is a condition on that. If N is even, both A and B must be non-negative. This is so important. If it is even, no problem. Look here. If the index of the root is odd, we could have it positive or negative. At the end of the previous class, I have asked you, what is the square root of A squared? And some of you, they said it is A. Is it correct?
No.
It is not always true. It is not, if you said that it is A, it is not always true. It is true only if what? Look here. If A is four, let me show you here. If A is four, what will happen? What will be the square root of A squared? It will be the square root of four squared, which is the square root of 16, which is what? So it is A. The square root of A squared, it is A if A is positive. So here I'm talking about a positive A, like four. What about if A is negative? Like what? Like A equals negative four. What will happen? The square root of A squared will be the square root of negative four to the power two, which is the square root of 16, which is what?
Four.
It is four again. I told you that this symbol, shabab, what is inside it is positive. What is outside of this is what?
Positive.
To be more accurate, positive or zero. Positive or zero, negative, non-negative. This is why we say it in negative. Okay, so what is the relationship between four and negative four? So is this A? This is not A. This is negative A.
Yes.
This is negative A. What is A? What was A, if you remember? It is negative, negative four. So this is four. So it is negative A. So the square root of A squared is A. If A is positive, so it is A if A is positive or zero. And it is negative A if A is what? Is negative. What is this? This is indeed the definition of the absolute value. And this is how we will define the absolute value of A. The absolute value of any expression, the absolute value of whatever, the absolute value of whatever equals to this whatever. If this whatever is positive or zero, non-negative, and it is the negative of this whatever, if this whatever is what? Is negative. Usually we say A, shabab, for simplicity. Okay, now I think now we can generalize this. Let me show you this in the properties of radicals. We have mentioned yesterday for you, but not with other sections, the properties of radicals. Here they are. The properties of radicals. Let me start with the one that is related to the last one that we, this one. What is the one that is related to this? Here it is. Okay, number five. So it is a generalization, the more general. The nth root of A to the power N, we were having two here, but we don't write two in the index of the root. It will be the absolute value of A if N is even. طبعاً يا شباب, if A is positive, no need here. The absolute value will be the same as A. Now, if it is odd, if N is odd, it is A, whether it is positive or negative, it doesn't matter. For the odd roots, we don't require A to be positive. No problem. Okay. Now, here we have what? The root of the product is the product of the roots. We can distribute the radical or the root over the product and over the quotient also. The root of the quotient is the quotient of the root. You can also think about it, shabab, from the left to the right. If it is like this, you can write it like this. If it is like this, you can write it like this. Here you have an example about that. The root of the root, when you have a radical of another radical, it is an example here. For example, this is 2. 2 times 3 will be 6. There is a condition here, Shabab, that you have to be careful when you apply. Here, these rules, all of them, but I'd like to focus on these three. Here, what is inside? The radical must be positive, must be in a negative if n is what?
Even.
If is even. So you cannot apply these rules if the radicand, what is inside the radical is not positive. Let me give you an example. What is the square root of negative 2 times negative 8? Is it the same? I'm asking, is it the same as the square root of negative 2 times the square root of negative 8?
No.
It is not. You cannot apply this because look what is this. This is the square root of 16, which is what?
4.
But this one we will see later. This is in fact the square root of 2i. The I of the square root of 2 times the I of the square root of 8. We will take this in chapter 1, the complex numbers. And we will show you there that it will be negative 4, not 4. Okay, so they are not the same. So when we apply these rules, now we are doing this for real numbers. So here, A, here, A must be positive and B must be positive if N is even. If it is odd, no problem. I expect, Shabab, now that you will be able to solve this old example. The number of rational numbers in this set is. So when he asks about the number of, he is asking about how many. So it is the same like saying how many rational numbers in this set. How to do that, ya shabab? We will go over them one by one. So the first number, 0, is it rational or irrational?
Rational.
So this is rational. Any integer, ya shabab, is rational. Because why it is rational? Because it is 0 over what?
1.
0 over 1. So it is 0. Negative 4,
rational,
because also it is what? Integer, any integer is rational. It is negative 4 over 1. 3.14, are you sure?
Yes.
How it is rational? Can you write it as integer over integer?
Yes.
Yes. This is 314 over 100. You are right. So it is. And the reason, if someone asks you about this, what is the best answer for this question? Yes. It is a terminating decimal. Allah irda alayk. Yes, it is. Yes, but every repeating decimal or every terminating decimal is a rational number. Square root of 3?
Irrational.
It is irrational, not rational. So this is not. Why it is not? You cannot. There is a proof, a mathematical proof for that. You cannot write it never ever as an integer over integer. And also it is what, Shabab? It is non-repeating, non-terminating decimal. So it is not. So this one is what? Irrational. Okay? Now, negative 2.17359 repeated.
Rational.
Why it is irrational? You can write it as a integer over integer, as a rational number. So it is. Every repeating is what is rational. Pi over 3.14.
Rational.
Yeah, Shabab, this is 1. Pi over 3.14, is it 1?
No.
It is not 1. Because pi is not 3.14. Be careful. So this is a fraction. So why it is not rational? It is a fraction. It is numerator over denominator. It is not integer over integer. So this is not rational. So this is irrational number. Good. Now, square root of 64. So it is 8. Why this is irrational and this is rational? You should simplify, Shabab, before deciding that if it is rational or not. So this is also, of course, what? This is, of course, is also rational. So it is just equals to 8. The cubic root of negative 8, this is equals to negative 2, so it is rational also. 12 over 6, it is in fact 2 also, but it is clear that it is integer over integer. Negative 7 over square root of 4, why? You should simplify. So this is negative 7 over? What about negative 7 over square root of 7?
No.
It is irrational. Okay, excellent, Shabab. Now, let me ask you this question. What about pi over 2 pi? Is it rational? Simplify. What we learn from this question, because there are many questions like this in the old exam. Before deciding that it is integer or not integer, rational or not rational, you should simplify first. Any question, Shabab? Yes, please.
You said it must be integer over integer.
Yes. Right? Any this is how we define the rational numbers.
Rational over rational, or
it is at the end integer over integer. What about this, for example? 3.5 over 6.2. It is rational. Why? Because this is 35 over 10. Good question. And this is 62 over 10. Now, if you simplify it, it will be 35 over 10. Multiply by 10 over 62. It will be 10 will be with cancelled here, and you will have 35 over 62. Integer over integer. Of course. This is, of course, when we have the denominator shouldn't be zero. Of course, if it is zero, it is undefined. So how many, Shabab, we have? We forget to count. So now 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 8 numbers that they are rational, and 2 numbers they are not irrational. Yes, please.
Pi over 3.14 is not is irrational because pi approximately.
Not approximately. We are talking about it exactly. Pi is not rational. Pi is not rational. Yeah. What is your name? Ahmed. Yeah, Ahmed. Pi is not rational. You are dividing it by a number that is whatever, rational or not, it is not rational. And if you simplify, you cannot simplify this. Can you simplify it to get rational number? Can you get at the end integer over integer?
No.
No, so it is, this is why it is not. Clear, Shabab?
Yes.
Okay, now I think also you are able now to solve these questions in the assignment. But again, this is not the target. This is easy, Shabab. I know that some of you, they know, mashallah, that it is directly, it is 14. Because 14 times 14 is 169. But this is not the question. The idea from giving you this question, Shabab, is to refresh your memory about how to find the square root, the cubic root, whatever. How to find the root of a real number, of a number that is small or big, whatever. What is the answer for this question? How to find the square root of a number? How? Please.
To write it as a product of fact, to factor it.
Yeah. So the idea is to factor it. So what will be, Shabab? 196, we will factor it. What is it? It can be divided by 2, 89, and 98. Divide by 2 again, 49. It cannot be divided by 2, so it is divided by 7. 7 is a prime number. It can be divided only by itself, so we are done. So now the square root of 196 is equal to, let me write here, it will be equal to the square root of 2 to the power 2 times 7 to the power? 2 to the power 2, 7 to the power 2. Now if you remember the rules that we mentioned here, this is why I give you this. Now I can distribute the radical over the product. Now this will be the square root of 2 to the power 2 times the square root of 7 to the power 2. Now, this one also we have shown you this, that the nth root of 2. Now this is of course the absolute value of 2, but 2 is positive.
But we don't need.
The absolute value of 7 is 7, which is what? You can do that now for any number, not just for this one, 196. You got it, ya Shabab? This is what I meant by solution. When I ask you to solve it, you just give me the final answer. I ask, where are the steps? How did you know that? Now, similarly, you can do here, Shabab. Here, you can do the same. If you can deal with decimal numbers, it's okay. But if you cannot, the best way to do is to convert it to what?
Fraction.
To fraction. And you can, of course, write this as like 3,025 over 100. You can now distribute the radicals by the properties of radicals. Square root of 100. Now the square root of 100 is easy, 10, because it is 10 times 10. Now for this one, it is not direct. What you need to do, you need to factor it again. Of course, it cannot be divided by 2. It cannot be divided by 3. Divide by what?
Five.
By 5. Now when you divide by 5, 3 over 5 cannot be divided exactly. So 30 over 5, 6, 25 over 5 is 5. Is that right? No, it is not. Impossible, ya shabab, that 5 times 65 is 3,000. Come on. So what is missing here? If it is not clear for you, it is better to do it as a long division. So please do it as a long division. It is much easier. Now, what I want you to do here, you can do the long division here. 30 over 5 is 6. 5 times 6 is 30. Now, 2 cannot be divided by 5. So we'll bring it down, so we will to bring a 0. Now, it is 25 over 5 is 5. Now, it makes sense now. 600, when you multiply by 5, it is, yes, 3,025. Again, it can be divided by 5. So what is it? 6 over 5 is 1. 1, it will be 10. 10 divided by 5 is 2. 5 divided by 5. Now, this one can be divided only by what? By 11. 11 is a prime number. It can be divided by itself. Divided by itself, this is 1. So now what we can do here, shabab, this is the square root of what? 5 to the power 2 multiplied by 11 to the power 2. This is 5 times 11 over 10. You can say that this is 55 over 10. This is 5.5. This is, ya shabab, the method that I advise you to do for any decimal number that you want to find its root. But for this specific one, there is another method that you can use, but unfortunately it is a shortcut that may work with this one, but it may not work with others. Yeah. So we should know what is the main method, and then we can go to the shortcut. Yeah, shabab, if you look at this, it is 30.25. It is just, if you write it as a mixed number, it is 30 and 4. And this one, if you convert it to fraction, it will be what? 121 over 4, which is 11 over 2, which is 5.5. Excellent. I expect now you can solve, ya shabab, the last one. So easy. After solving this, you will be able to solve the last one. You can do it in two methods. Maybe more, but you can just do this subtraction, shabab. 0.25 minus 0.16. So it will be 0.09. Okay, now this is the square root of 0.09. And it will be what?
9 over 100.
It is 9 over 100. So it is 3 over 10. It is 0.3. Okay, if you didn't do it this way, you can do it, of course, from the beginning. It will be 25 over 100 minus 16 over 100, which is what? 9 over 100, and you can continue. Excellent. I think now we are ready, shabab, to go to the next part of this section, which is the order of operations. Let's play the game of true or false. Look at this. Here we have 6 times 5 plus 3. We have two ways. You can add 5 plus 3 and then multiply by 6, or multiply 6 by 5 and then add 3. The first one is true and the second one is false. Look at the result. They are completely different. Okay? So why this is wrong, Yeshua?
Because he only multiplied by 6 by 5.
To make it correct, what we should do, we should multiply by 5 plus 6 by what?
Three.
Which is the distributive property. So here he didn't apply the distributive property in the right way. So when we have a shabab multiplication and addition with the brackets, you have to start with the parentheses or the brackets. Parentheses and brackets should be first when you deal with any operations. Let's see this. 5 times 2 to the power 2, it is 5 times 4, it is 20. But if you did it this way, multiply 5 by 2, it is wrong. Why? Because we should always start with what? With exponents, yes, shabab. Here you have 2 to the power 2. In fact, it is 5 times 2 times 2. So this is why it should be done like this. Okay? Now, next one. When you have multiplication and division, addition and subtraction, what should you start with first? Start by multiplication and division first, and then add and subtract. Okay? For here, when you have this, 2 plus 5 times 3, start by 5 times 3. Then add 2. What about this, shabab? If it was like this, 2 plus 5 times 3, but we have a brackets here. What it will be? It will be 7 times 3, which will be 20. This will be the right answer. So be careful when you have brackets. We said the parentheses are first. The last one is, Shabab, when you have division and multiplication, which one you should start with? Go from the left to the right. So start with what is at the beginning and then go to the next one. So how to recall this, Shabab? How to remember all of this? Pim das. Pim das. What is that? P for parentheses, and E for exponent, MD for multiplication and division, and AS for what? For addition and subtraction. And if you have the same at the same time, start by from the left to the right. You can, of course, do it this way. I think now you can solve this, Shabab. I'm sure that you can. Please, in your notes, solve this question and give me your final answer. Give me your final answer. I will pause the recording to take the attendance, Shabab. Is your answer is one of these answers, Shabab?
Yes.
If you are lucky, it will be one of them. Also, if it is not one of them, you are also lucky because you will know that your answer is not correct. You will be unlucky if your answer is there, but it is not the right answer. So which answer is the right answer, Shabab?
A.
Any answer other than A? All of you agree about A? Great. So it is A. Now look, ya Shabab, how can you do it? Of course, in a short way. You can do it in several ways, but of course you have to follow the order of operations. So the order of operations is Shabab here. So this is equals to, this will be equals to. Now look here, you can add negative 2 plus 11 over 5. It's okay. But do you notice that here you have the same number and it's negative? So this will be canceled. What is the cancellation here? In fact, it is in fact, by the way, there is no difference here, Shabab, between the square brackets and the curvy brackets like this. All of them are parentheses. So now it will be negative 2 plus 0. The cancellation here is adding a number with its additive inverse. So it is negative 2 plus 0 divided by, now, Shabab, this is also, we have brackets here. We should work inside the parentheses. These are fractions, Shabab. I show you how to do that. So it is, the LCD is 12, and it will be 4 minus 3, which is what? Now, here it will be minus. What we have here, Shabab? This is 4. Is it 9 or negative 9? It is negative 9 because here the base is 3, not negative 3. You have to distinguish between negative 3 to the power 2, which is 9, and negative 3 squared, in fact, which is negative 1 multiplied by 3 to the power 2. This is negative 1 multiplied by 9. This is negative 9. So it is negative 9 plus 2. Great. Now this is equals to what? Negative 2 divided by 1 over 12. No need for the brackets here, Shabab, here, because we finished the operation. Now this is negative of negative A. It is what? It is A. So here negative times negative is positive 9 over 4 plus 2. What about cancellation now? This negative 2 with this 2, is it correct?
No.
Who said yes? Say no problem. Don't be sorry. It is not correct, Shabab. Be careful. It is not correct. You cannot cancel. This is negative 2 divided by 12, 1 over 12. So this is, Shabab, you should do the same order of operations that we show you before. So this is what? This is equals to negative 2 multiplied by 12 plus 9 over 4 plus 2. Can we cancel now 2 with negative 2?
No.
Not yet. Negative 2 is multiplied by 12. So it is negative 24 plus 9 over 4 plus 2. Now you can add, but I advise you when you have your Shabab integers and the rational numbers, add the integers together and then add them to the. So what I can do here, I can use the commutative property. This is plus 2 plus 9 over 4. Now it will be clear that negative 24 plus 2, it is negative 22 plus 9 over 4. Now you have an integer plus a rational number. The LCD is 4. This will be negative 88 plus 9 or over 4, all equals to negative 79 over 4, which is 8. Excellent. Now, I think we have time to go to the next part. The next part, ya Shabab, of this section is the real line. Okay, which line I'm talking about here? Not the line in the zoo. They are pronounced the same, by the way. the line in math or the geometry, this is the line. Now, who can give me, remind me about the integers, ya shabab? What are the integers? Give me, can we list the integers? Can we start counting them? Give me a list of these numbers. 1, 2, 3, and so on. 0, -1. By the way, I notice, ya shabab, that most of you, they read this as -1. It is better to, it is not, of course, it is not a problem. It is not wrong, but ya shabab, mathematically, 2 - 3 equals to what? To -1. This is how to read it, ya shabab. 2 - this is minus, but this is negative. When we subtract, when we're talking about subtraction, we say minus. When we talk about the sign of the number, is it positive or negative? We say negative. So this is, we don't read this as 2 - 3 equals to -1. It is better, of course, correctly to write, to read it as 2 - 3 equals to -1. Great. Now, who can give me, a shabab, an integer? Give me an integer between 1 and 2. A half, is it between 1 and 2? 1.5. I asked about an integer. Is it integer? So 3/2, it is here. It is between 1 and 2, but it is not integer. Is there any integer between 1 and 2? No integers, ya shabab. The integers are 0, jump to 1, jump to 2, and so on. So give me a rational number between 1 and 2. Here it is, 3/2. Give me a rational number between 1 and 2. √2, √3 also, they are there. So can you give me all the rational numbers between 1 and 2?
No.
They are infinite numbers, ya shabab. Of course, we cannot, but a list of them. We cannot list them. Also similarly between 0 and 1, how many real numbers between 0 and 1? Infinitely many. If you put your finger here, wherever you will put your finger here, you will be on what? On a real number. There are here infinitely many real numbers. Between any two rational numbers, there is a rational number. Between any two rational numbers, there is irrational number. And so on. You can play this game forever. Okay? So what is the criteria, shabab? How to represent them? How to represent these real numbers? Every point is what here? On this line, every point is what? No, every point here is what? Is a real number. Be careful. Here it is not integer. So every point here is what? And every point is a real number, and every real number is a point on the
line.
On this line. We will call this line. Here it is. It is better than mine, shabab. Now this is the real line. Every point here is a real number, and every real number can be represented as a point. This point, shabab, it is 1, and we call it in the language of the geometry coordinates. So this is the coordinate of the point 1. This is the coordinate of the point -1, and so on. Okay? This is, ya shabab, the point in the middle here. The point at the middle here, which is 0, is the boundary between the positive numbers and the negative. We will call it the origin. So this is now new vocabulary that you can add, ya shabab, to your vocabulary in this course. Now, this is the positive direction. When you go to the right, you are going in the positive direction. And when you go to the left, this is the negative. What is the middle in between them? The 0. So the criteria between the positivity and negativity, it is what? The 0. So because of that, we will say that A is negative if it is less than, because look at the numbers to the left of 0. All of them are what? Are negative. Now, if it is to the right of 0, if it is greater than 0, it is what? Positive. Now, if A is negative, its negative will be what? If A is negative, its negative is what? It's positive. If you multiply a negative number by -1, it will be positive. Similarly, if A is positive, its negative is negative. Okay? You can answer this question, I'm sure now. This is also a recitation question. Let A, B, and C be real numbers such that A is what? Positive. And B is what? Negative. C is negative. Then what is the sign of each expression? negative b, negative b will be positive or negative? Less than zero or greater than zero? Because b is negative, its negative will be, so it will be greater than zero. Don't, ya shabab, think about a specific number. You should be able, I have noticed in the previous class that some of you, they solve it, how they solve it. They consider a, for example, to be one, and b to be negative one, and so on. But this is the, you, this is not the right way to do that. The right way to be able to decide whatever a is, whatever b is, okay? According to what is given for you. So when we say a greater than zero, it means any real number that is positive. Now, a minus c, is it positive or negative? Greater than zero or less than zero? You should go back to the definition of the subtraction. A minus c, it is a plus minus negative c. It is a plus minus, sorry. It is a minus c equals to a plus negative c. This is how we define the subtraction. Now, this is what, ya shabab? A is what?
A is
greater than zero. And negative c is what? C is negative. C is less than zero. But negative c will be what? So it will be positive number plus a positive number. It is a positive number plus a positive number. So it will be what? It will be a positive number, greater than zero. So A minus C will be positive. Now, what about this? AB, positive or negative?
Negative.
It will be in positive times negative. So this is negative plus
negative.
A times C is also negative. So negative plus negative, it will be a negative number. AB squared, A is what?
A
is positive and B squared for any B, ya shabab, for any B, if you square it, it will be always what? Whether B is positive or negative, it will be always positive. So it will be what? It will be positive. Great. Now, the real numbers are ordered. What does that mean? We can order them, ya shabab. If I give you a real number A, there are three possibilities. Three possibilities. There is no third possibility, a fourth possibility. Negative or positive or zero. Now, if I give you two numbers, there are two possibilities. A is less than zero or it is equal to B. They are either equal to each other or one of them is less than the another one. A is less than B or B is greater than A. There is no third possibility. Now, look here, A is less than B if what? If B minus A is positive. 3 is less than 7, why? Because 7 minus 3 is what? When you subtract the smaller one from the bigger one, it will be positive. If you subtract the bigger one from the smaller one, it will be negative. In fact, geometrically, it means that A is on the left. What is on the left is the smaller. What is on the right is what? The bigger. This is why negative 3 is less than 1. Because negative 3 is to the left of 1. Any negative number, ya shabab, is less than 0. And 0 is less than any positive number. So any negative number is less than any positive number. We can read this as A is less than B, or we can read it as what? B is greater than A. You can write it this way or this way. They are the same. Just you read it from the right to the left. If we add or equals, if you want to say or equal, you can add this just notation. Just less than or equal, greater than or equal. Here we have some examples about negative y is less than negative 3, square root of 2, it is less than 2, and so on. Now, how to compare between fractions, ya shabab? Let me ask you this. This is easy. 3/5 or a half, clearly a half is smaller. So a half is a smaller 3/5. It is so easy. How to show it if you have other fractions? Yes.
We multiply the numerator of the first one with the denominator
of the next one. Here it is. The answer is here, shabab. If you have A over B and C over D, how to compare between them? How to know which one is smaller, which one is bigger? You need just to do cross multiply A times D and C times B. Let me show you here, but there is a condition here, shabab. The denominators must be what?
Non-zero
and non-negative, positive. Here, we have here 3/5 and 1/2. Assume that we don't know which one is bigger, we will apply that one. So we will do cross multiply, 2 times 3, 1 times 5?
Five.
Now, who is bigger, 6 or 5?
Six.
6 is bigger, so this is also bigger.
We can do it by the LCD, right?
You can do by the LCD, but of course it will be like that. Of course, his idea to use the LCD is also easy. When you have the same denominator, it will be easy just compare the numerator. Okay, but you have to be careful, Shabab, when you have negative numbers. Let me give you, for example, this. Negative 3 and 5, which one is smaller, which one is bigger? Negative 3 over 5, is, of course, it is less than. Why? Any negative number is less than any positive number, because it is negative and that's positive. And you can use this cross-multiply to show it. But be careful, Shabab. This condition here that I bought here, it is not for fun. It is important. If you didn't consider this, you may be in trouble. Let me, for example, give you this mistake. 3 over negative 5, if it is like that. And what you will do if you do the cross multiply? Look, 2 times 3?
6.
6. 1 times negative 5? 6 is what?
Bigger.
Bigger. So is this bigger?
No.
No. So this is not true. So be careful when you do this. This is a common mistake that of course. So if it is negative 3 over 5, one sum of, you asked me about this in the previous class. What about this? The same way, you can apply this rule. This rule, it said if B and C, A and C here are any real number, no problem. You can do it in two ways. You can do the cross multiply. Multiply, it will be negative 6, and here negative 5. Which one is bigger, which one is smaller? Negative 6 is less than. It's less than. Or just think about 3 over 5. It is what? It is greater than a half. If you multiply by negative 1, we will take this later, inshallah. When we multiply by negative, it will be reverse. This will be reverse when we multiply by negative 1. Okay? Yes.
So the sign should be in the numerator, right?
Yes. And of course, ya shabab, you should always think about who is on the left, who is on the right, to think about it geometrically. Maybe in the next class, inshallah, we will start talking about sets of numbers. We already did talk about this concept. We, for example, before we talked about the set of the natural numbers, the set of integers. So all the integers, they are a set of numbers. So to think about a set, it is a collection of objects in general. But here, of course, we are talking about a collection of numbers. We will stop here and continue next class, inshallah. Thank you and see you, Shabab.